How do I do this? Hi all, we just learned L'Hopital's rule. I was doing the worksheet and I got confused on how to solve number 3. Okay, let's take a look. We are going to evaluate the limit as x approaching 0 of ln of 1 minus cosine x minus ln of x squared. So firstly, I will tell you, we will have an indeterminate form and it's unfortunately not 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity, but it's okay. Notice we have two natural logs and they are subtracting, so we can combine them. Let's just do that right away. This is the limit as x approaching 0. One natural log, this over that because of the log property. So 1 minus cosine x over x squared. Okay, now, if we put 0 into all the x's, cosine 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. If you put 0 right here, 0 squared is 0, so inside here, we do have 0 over 0, but we still have the ln on the outside. So what do we do? Do we just take the derivative with a natural log? Well, actually, no. Here's a small technical part. In fact, whenever we are calculating the limit of a ln function, we can do this inside out. Meaning, just focus on the inside, take the limit, and after that, do the ln. And the reason we can do this is because ln is a continuous function. I'm going to put it on the outside. And then we bring the limit inside. And we're just focusing on computing this limit first. Okay, now for the inside, of course, we are just having the 0 over 0. So we can use L'Hopital's rule. And to do so, we can just go ahead, take the derivative on the top, and also take the derivative on the bottom. So, on the outside, we still have ln, and then we still look at the limit. As x approaching 0, derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of negative cosine gives us positive sine x, over derivative of x squared gives us 2x. Now, if you just focus on this, when you put 0 into here and here, sine 0 is 0, 2 times 0 is 0, so we still have 0 over 0. So it looks like we can still use L'Hopital's rule, right? So if your teacher is okay with that, go ahead, be my guest, do L'Hopital's rule, and then just work that out, and then get the answer out of it, and you're done. I don't mind if your teacher is okay. But this is the limit that I have so much to say. So I'm going to put a 1 half on the outside, so this is just a little note. If you look at the limit as x approaching 0 of this limit, sine x over x, we actually need to know this limit first before we can do the derivative of sine x. If you look back to my other videos, I have made discussion on that before, or if you look at the proof of the derivative of sine x, you need to know this limit. So we cannot technically take the derivative of sine x when we are trying to find the derivative of sine x. So what do? I will try to tell you. Usually I just tell my students that if you see this kind of limit, just quote the result. This right here is equal to 1. And I'm totally okay with it. I'm not so okay if you do L'Hopital's rule here. No. So that doesn't matter that much if your teacher is okay or not, but anyway. So I will have ln right here. Notice we have the 1 half right here, so I will just put that down right here. 1 over 2 can be brought up to the outside, and then the limit as x approaching 0 of sine x over x is just 1. So it's just 1. So in fact, the answer is ln of 1 half, like this, or notice 1 half is the same as 2 to the negative 1 power, so we can write ln of 2 to the negative 1, bring the power to the front, but don't minus 1, this is just a log property, it's not the power rule for the derivative, so you can also write this as negative ln 2. Alright, so hopefully this right here helps. And again, perhaps the most controversial limit. Anyway.